Good morning, guys. Welcome to Life of Paulos. Happy to have you here. So a lot of interesting things have been put out there on the internet, apparently about me, over the last 24 hours. And I thought I would take 2 minutes to discuss some of them before we get into our normal news broadcast for the day. So let me start off first by saying that I'm not going to be speaking ill of anybody in this video. I'm not going to be posting, like, you know, private or personal conversations that I've had with any of the creators that I've talked to over the past year and a half. I find that privacy is a very important thing for the YouTube community, and I would never break that trust with the creators that I talk about. Even though during some of the more negative things said about me yesterday, my private and personal information was leaked online. So let me kind of set the table for you guys a little bit. So we covered about 3 days worth of all the allegations that were made against Alex Choi and Daily Driven Exotics and a whole slew of other creators. We reached out to Daily Driven Exotics to get their sort of version, their side of what happened in an effort to provide a more complete understanding of what actually occurred. And they provided me with like 4 different legal documents, including a 2-page police report and letters from the district attorney of Clark County. We aired that yesterday, basically reading everything verbatim, line by line, making sure that we got all the important points out, and then immediately I was attacked afterward. Now, one of the biggest claims that was made against me is that I'm secretly paid by Daily Driven Exotics to promote or skew material in their favor when I talk about them. Well, I can tell you this right now, I've never been paid by any channel, Daily Driven Exotics or Stradman or anyone to promote any of their material or change the way that I would normally view news material as I see fit. Now, obviously, we do talk about a lot of the same big creators because we found that that's actually what pushes engagement and growth in our channel, and generally that's what you guys want to see. We cover what's popular. That anyone would go out there and sort of promote a false narrative insinuating that I'm paid or bankrolled by Daily Driven Exotics is just, it's unfortunate and extraordinarily untrue. And last big thing here, guys, in the early days of my channel, I actually reached out to a number of large automobile channels to help market and promote my brand new channel at the time. Influencer marketing is one of the best possible ways to get visibility and traffic to a brand new enterprise. And Vehicle Virgins was one of the first channels to get back to me on that fact and do a shout out. And nothing he could ever say would ever make me feel anything but grateful for that fact. But that's it, guys. You know, commentary channels are commonplace all across YouTube. Everyone from like H3H3 to Philip DeFranco. And I find it unusual that someone would look at what we do, which is speculation on car purchases and covering YouTube altercations, as any different from them. And I'm not going to let anyone stop us from bringing you guys the coverage that you want. And with that, guys, into the news. All right, guys, first up on the slate today is actually Street Speed 717. If you guys remember, just about a week ago or so, he bought the beautiful Lamborghini SUV for his girlfriend, and now the time has come for him to buy his dream SUV as well. So in the video, he actually talks about potentially buying a Hummer H1, because that's what his dream SUV was. Excellent video. Love what Street Speed 717 is doing right now, and obviously the Lamborghini content, he talked about doing some potential mods to his girlfriend's Lamborghini, I think is going to be really fantastic for his channel. Obviously the views are following that insane content. Make sure to go check it out, guys, link in the description below. Next up, guys, Hoovy's Garage on why you should never buy a cheap BMW 7 Series. My goodness, is there a lot of stuff wrong with this particular car. I love the series from Hoovy's Garage, especially the stuff that he's been doing with his cheap Mercy he bought from Ed Bullion very recently. Make sure to go check it out, guys. Hoovy's Garage closing in on 1 million subscribers. If you've been a fan for him for a long time, it's so cool to see him get that close to 1 million subs. Great content coming out from him lately. Link in the description below. Tavares next up on the slate, guys, racing his cheap Honda Civic for the quarter mile. Everything Tavares has been doing right now has been just kind of absolute gold. Ever since he did the Pimp My Ride videos, all of his videos have been just smashing with monster views, 700,000 views plus, major increases in subscriber ranges across the board. If you're not following Tavares, you're missing out on a very cool segment of the automotive community. Shmee's up next, guys, with just a phenomenal video with the new Pagani Imola, one of only 5 that's ever going to be made in the world. We have an entire walk around, you know, discussion of what the car is all about, and actually get a chance to be in that car as it's being driven. What a cool experience. Like we talked about for a long time, Shmee just has some of the highest level automotive content in the community and has been doing so for about 10 years plus now. Over 3,000 videos at this point, just smashing it with a work ethic that is hard to match by anyone anyone else in the community, make sure to go watch this. The Pagani Imola is an incredible car, and Shmi reviewing it is even better. And don't forget, guys, Shmi has actually been doing a bunch of crossover episodes, one of their most recent ones put up on the Savage Garage channel, actually featuring their Ford GT and having a great time having Shmi in their vlog. Make sure to go check out Shmi's channel and Savage Garage's channel if you want to see the complete coverage of his trip to the US. And how can I not talk about the latest Washness Media video, the Liberty Walk GTR version 2. Everything that Washness Media puts out is fantastic. If you love cinematic content, Washness Media has some of the best stuff that you'll find out there on YouTube. Here's a very small clip. As you can see, guys, fantastic stuff. Make sure to go check it out. Link in the description for his channel is below. Royalty Exotics is next up on the slate with a really crazy video of a crazy person trying to steal his Corvette. Make sure to go watch it. Pretty ridiculous episode, getting tons of views right now on the Royalty Exotics channel. Next on the list, guys, Donut Media did an entire video on the bad driving habits that are sort of ruining the road for everyone involved. If you guys don't know Donut Media, they have one of the best possible channels in how they present car information. Very similar to like what VinWiki does with car stories, Donut Media does with, you know, everything you need to know about certain cars, getting up to speed on certain things that are happening in the automotive community, and their presentation is hands down the best in making you feel engaged in learning about these topics. Additionally, they're one of the largest automotive channels, period, now with over 3 million subscribers, a pretty astounding number. And if you guys remember, just about a month or two ago, they won a major award for being one of the best channels in that genre. So a big congrats to them once again. If you're not following Donut Media, you're missing out on just one of the coolest channels out there. And obviously the people that run it have a real love of cars. TJ Hunt has just a crazy video out making the Fast and Furious Toyota Supra into the 2020 version of that Supra. Pretty cool video overall. They match pretty much the entire exterior to it. It's a very fun loving video, and I'm assuming it's going to get a monster amount of traction. If you've been following all the stuff that TJ Hunt has been doing with his Supra, you're really going to enjoy this particular video. TJ Hunt, after buying his Aventador, now doing more stuff with the Supra, is on a roll right now. Make sure not to miss out on his content. And I feel like just about one out of every maybe like 5 or 6 videos for Tanner Fox, we get some sort of really cool supercar video. Tanner Fox, not traditionally an automotive YouTuber, but throws a lot of automotive content in his stuff from time to time, has a great video out basically picking up taxi riders in a Lamborghini. Obviously, this is a trend that we've seen on a number of channels. It's been very popular for a bunch of years on YouTube. We actually did something very similar with Uber on our channel a number of months ago, way before I started doing, you know, automotive news in general. Make sure to go check this out, guys. Tanner Fox has some great content when he sprinkles in supercar stuff. Make sure you don't miss it. And make sure to go check out Cletus McFarlane's latest video and Supercar Blondie's latest video. One basically more Freedom Factory, you know, shenanigans out there messing around with the tow truck they're trying to save. And then Supercar Blondie reviewing the most luxurious SUVs and comparing them. We're talking about the Black Badge Rolls-Royce Cullinan, as well as some crazy Mercedes as well. And with that, guys, that's the majority of the news that was out there today. Just want to thank everybody that supported the channel over the last couple months in particular. It's been just a real joy to bring you guys supercar community news as we see it. We've got a lot of really interesting things coming up. Trying to do more in-depth documentaries as we continue on. We'll have some more vlogs here sometime over the next couple months. Yeah, vlogs are not like the biggest concern for me, but every once in a while I think it's fun to do one. And then we've obviously got some additional questionnaire stuff with a Congress over COPPA that we're still following up with. Oh, and one side note here, guys, as we sort of end up the day. So I want you guys to list in the comments below some of the smaller creators, let's say under 50,000 subs at this point, that you would like to see featured. Maybe we can do like a segment on smaller YouTubers that need more of a boost. What's interesting is that we used to do a segment like that, but generally over time, the people that we used to cover that were like under 100,000 subs ended up breaking breaking through that barrier and just became sort of a normal occurrence to talk about. So all the small creators that we used to talk about no longer really fit that bill. And I'll need your guys' help to help me find smaller creators to push out there and get in front of you if you think that they're worthy of news coverage. So make sure in the comments below, let me know what smaller creators have not really been talked about yet on the channel. And maybe we can start doing like a small creator a day or every other day or some way to get publicity to channels that you think should be covered. So have a great Monday, guys. We'll see you tomorrow with normal news like every other day. And I think that's all I got. Yeah, have a great day. Bye.